I am a professional.
I have a feeling we're just gonna have to pry this lid off. Ugh. Do they just not want people opening these? It really is like an Apple product. Hey guys, how you all doing? Really? That's just great. You know who's not doing great? This poor sucker of a hard drive. You know, I plugged it in recently and it didn't quite work. I'll show you what happened. However, there is hope because the hard drive might be okay. The enclosure might just have some kind of power failure. So, we're gonna use this guy, the Nexstar TX by Vantech. Now, I was going to get a Rosewill version of a drive toaster, that's basically what this is, but I got one of those lovely, this may cause cancer in California warnings, and I'm like, well, that sounds great, I don't want that. So this one didn't have that, for some reason, and we're gonna use it to try to get that drive extracted. Well, we're gonna try to extract the drive from that enclosure, and then pop it into the drive toaster and see what we can pull off of it. Now, this is an old FireWire 800 drive. I used to video edit off of this thing back when FireWire 800 was magical. Not so much anymore. So it's been, needless to say, years since I have even looked at the contents of this disc. I have no idea what's on here. I think we might be in for a little surprise. Let's get started. All right, so step one of this whole process is to get the hard disk out of this enclosure. Now, much like an Apple product, it is completely sealed off. However, it is not as sealed off. We have these rubber feet on the bottom that hold up the device, but they also conceal the screws. Hopefully, it is really easy to just peel these suckers off. There we go, and it looks like it's just a little bit of adhesive. So that can go right back on if we need to. Now, this is an iOmega product. That's funny because I actually have another story about an iOmega drive that I almost destroyed. I'll tell that in a little bit. But yeah, I don't think iOmega even exists anymore, do they? Did they get acquired and the name got, like, removed or something? Do they not use the brand name anymore? I don't know. But yeah, I think iOmega got acquired or something like that. I used to buy their products quite a bit. Come on, baby! Ugh. That was a sticky one. We bust out our good friend Phillips screwdriver. Open this baby up. That is way too small. If I had a nickel for every time I heard that one. My other Phillips screwdrivers are not in this box I have over to the side, so we'll just use one of these little interchangeable bit doohickeys. Let's see if. There we go. That works. That's happy. How come, like, every time around this time of year, I have to undo an enclosure to extract a drive? The last time I did that around this time, it was with an SSD, and Juraga 1 gave me his wonderful wisdom. Yeah, it's like this time of year is cursed with, like, enclosure and drive issues. That's weird. I didn't think the Krazy Ken curse was, you know, that timely and organized. All right, well, we got the screws out, but it still feels like it's sealed up. Great. Whoops, almost forgot. Before I go any further, let me show you the wonderful sound this thing makes. It's not that bad, but. So. Turn it on. And as you can hear, it's just kind of going zzz, 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 not working. Okay, so I'm doing my best here with my amazing 3G signal that I'm getting to find out how to actually open up these suckers. Now, a lot of the videos either don't show the steps all the way and they have a massive amount of dislikes, or they do show the steps and it looks like we're gonna have to, like, stick knives into this frickin' case to pop the bottom off. So, I don't know how much additional research I really want to do, because I have a feeling we're just gonna have to pry this lid off, kind of like the old Mac Minis. The screws are out, but this thing will not budge, so we need to pry. You know, originally as a joke, I was just gonna smash this thing with a hammer to open it up, but I'm starting to think that's what we might actually have to do. The only problem is the contents that we need to extract from this frickin' bulletproof case are very fragile, so we need to be careful with that. Honestly, if I have to pry the case open and damage it, I don't care, because the enclosure doesn't seem to work anyway. I just want the hard disk out of here in one piece, please. And... okay. Something a little more durable, I think, is doing the trick. This is a very bizarre case. Okay. And le voilà, there we are. So here's the disc. It looks like we have a couple more screws to take out, but I'm gonna guess that the hard part is over. Ooh, I should never say that. The nice thing about this particular disassembly is, again, I don't have to worry about putting it back together because the thing doesn't work anyway, so screw it. Or unscrew it. Ho ho ho! That pun was so good. Oh, I'm proud of myself. Okay, screw fine. Stay in there. I don't care. What the heck is this? What is this? Come on! It's like there's always screws to undo, but every time I undo them, there's like still something else retaining the enclosure. This is like a frickin' puzzle box. This kind of reminds me of the time I disassembled the matte color classic, which coincidentally is actually sitting like 4 feet away from me. Yeah, that was a fun time. That thing was kind of a bitch to open too. And even worse, I had to get that thing reassembled because it needed to keep working afterwards. For this, I don't know. I really don't care if I just break the whole thing as long as the disc is good. I should probably have eye protection on. I'm just gonna look away. Ah, I can't get this frickin' thing open. I don't know if this is due to something we've already taken apart slash broken, but look at that. The disc is, okay, so the screws were holding this in place. Okay, so this is kind of just loose, which is good. Now I just need to get it out of here. Okay, so I'm looking up some other videos on the tubes, and most of them show the important parts of the procedure outside of the camera frame, which is genius cinematography. So I guess we're just on our frickin' own. But from what I am kind of gathering from the genius cinematography, is that this side probably comes off as well, and you don't take the disc out of the bottom here, but, oop, well that was probably stupid, but you take it out of the top. So, over the top it is. I don't like to do it this way, but I can't, like, I've been spending so much freaking time with this thing already, it's like, come on, man, just open. Man, never buying one of these things again, but I think the brand doesn't exist anymore anyway, so whatever. Okay, it looks like there's some little, like, notches there. Are they on the other side? Yes, they are. I saw some other videos where people were, like, cutting these open with knives. It's like, what the frick? Ugh. Cheese and rice. And this is also adhesive. What? Do they just not want people opening these? It really is like an Apple product. Well, there we are. Looks like it's a Samsung disc. And there it is. The remains of this beautiful work of art. Wow. Seriously. So like, who on the board or like the product design team just got together in a room and was like, hey, let's design the thing like a puzzle box so no one can get inside of it, ho ho. Yeah, I don't know why they thought that was a good idea, but regardless, we have the drive out now. 3.5 inch, and if I did my homework right, we should be able to just slip this into the toaster, and everybody should be happy. Let's open this thing up. That was a failed attempt. Oh, now I went through the cardboard, okay. This is actually pretty Pretty decent packaging for a frickin' $15 drive toaster.
Installation guide.
Bon appetit, there we are. Look at that, just... This is satisfying. I can have fun with that. So, we have USB 3 and DC. Now, if you'll recall, the enclosure I had earlier is USB 2, so this is gonna be way faster. Not to mention, this is gonna be way easier to use because we don't have to do any assembly. You just pop the disc in and you're good to go. Now, the advantage with the other enclosure is you can actually turn an internal hard drive into an external hard drive and it's pocket size, but I don't really care about that. I just want access to, for example, internal drives, and I just, you know, pop them in there. All right, so we got the power. Undo the little twisty twist. We can do this. Trust me, I am a professional. I am how to basic. No, I'm not. Just kidding. That'd be a disappointment. USB 3. This is type B to type A. All right, power. We got a little, you know, switch on the back there and a little light on the front. It's blue and red. That must mean something. So, let's actually get this hooked up to a computer. Here we are, all hooked up. Well, almost. All right, where's the port? All right, where are you? There you are, okay. All right, little Nexstar. Let's see if you were worth it. Inserting the breakfast pastry. Power up. Ooh. It's spinning! Dude, if this works, I'm gonna crap myself. Enter the password to unlock the disk Spica. Spica! Alright, that just really dates this thing. Yeah, I used to name my disks like after stars and stuff. Yeah, that was years ago. Alright, gotta figure out the password now. Huh. Uh-huh. Well, yeah. All of that just for nothing. Okay. Would you excuse me for a second? Just a second. Yeah.
Yeah.
Admittingly, I lost my cool here. I'm guessing this is not the best way to fix the hard drive. Yeah, that's busted. Well, on the bright side, however, I now have a 1 terabyte hard drive that has nothing on it. I could use this to store my research, to store my videos, to help further the advancement of mankind, or just let it sit in the closet and collect dust. Terabyte is still good. It's not too bad. So, how can we go out on a high note? I mean, this is kind of a high note. This is like a mid note. Let's go out on a higher note. It's story time with Krazy Ken. So I was kind of alluding to this earlier, and some of you may know this story, but long ago I had another iOmega product. It was actually the first iOmega product I ever purchased. I forgot what it was called, but it was an external hard drive, FireWire 400. The funny thing was the shape. Me being the good, kind, church-going Krazy Ken that I was, I didn't know much about alcohol or booze. So I'm carrying this hard drive around completely oblivious to what it actually kind of looks like. And I was at a birthday party one time. A birthday party when I was getting together with some of my other geeky friends, and I had the hard drive with me. And someone was like, and again, this was like back in middle school, they were like, "Is that a flask?" It struck me. That hard drive looks like a flask. iOmega shaped their hard drive to look like a flask. So now it lives in infamy as the flask drive. And that, ladies and gentlemen and ladies, is my story for you today. I'm calling this a win. I'm a little cold now. Oh, I hope I don't get sick. Thanks for taking along. Catch the crazy and pass it on. It's contagious.